Our people to escape from slavery, and they all somehow Gene Wick from Judy Book, Lions Book in Genesis 49. And it says about, if you want to read that, it says about God, it says a truth shall overcome him, but he shall overcome at the last. So what took down the devil tried to kill him? And read it. The North American cavalry, the military of this damn prophet. But what did the cavalry say? That he shall overcome at the last. How did he overcome? How did he overcome? By killing this great man. Genesis 49:8. Judah, thou art he whom thy brethren shall praise. Thy hand shall be in the neck of thy enemies. Thy father's children shall bow before thee. Judah is the lion's whelp. From the throne my son thou art gone up. He stooped down, he couched as a lion, and as an old lion, who shall rouse him up? Yeah, you black men, your own lions, man. So the question being posed is, who shall rouse him up? Who's gonna rouse him up? Who's gonna rouse him up? The Most High is gonna rouse him up. Your higher power is gonna have a child. That's who's gonna rouse you up. Are you gonna fly upon the back, the necks of the Philistines? Matter of fact, give me that too. Isaiah 11 and 10. Zechariah 9:12. Come me to the stronghold, you prisoners of hope. Even to God do I declare that I will render double unto thee. When I have begged Judah for me, you're the bow of Ephraim. Yeah, because when that thing happens, is when the tribes, you notice that it mentions Judah for Ephraim. Correct? The Most High said he's gonna use Judah as Ben Judah, meaning Judah's gonna be the bow, alright? And Ephraim gonna be the arrows. Now I ain't just talking about the tribe of Judah and the tribe of Ephraim. I was talking about all the tribes coming together. But it mentioned Judah because Judah was the head of the kingdom of Judah, of the southern kingdom. And Ephraim was the head of the northern kingdom. When they had that split, during the time of Rehoboam and Jeroboam, they had that split, which is a lot of prophecy. So now that split is coming back together. That's why you see so many camps out there. And then you know what? You hoping like hell. We're going to beat somebody down and we're going to beat them. Yeah, you know, we don't do that, man. You can beat down with your words. Because with these brothers from these different camps, in these different states, in these different countries, they're in the beginning, they ain't going on physically. They got their little scuffles. We do the same thing. All right? Back going back in the 80s, we got a brother right here that got witness that back in the 80s, man, that was fights every goddamn week, man. How do we go fights, stuffers? But you don't see that no more because we're all disciplined now. We're all disciplined now. Because what are we doing? We're beating the hell out of you with this word, man. We're hitting you with that football truth. We're hitting you with the right, the back of righteousness, man. All right? And we're hitting you with the cloak of truth. You can talk down and beat down on a spiritual level, man. You can get knocked out and kicked in the head and thrown out and you can get back up, right? You can see. Once you see this in your ass, you go down, you ain't getting back up, man. Yeah, a lot of these guys think I'm not killing yourself, man. Boy, Jeremiah, the book of Jeremiah 5 and 4. You know, Nate, the last video that he made was on the Heights. He won't spend an hour and change speaking about the Heights. But that's important. You're a real, but you know what? When I saw that video, I said, man, he's running out of things to teach. Yeah, but Jeremiah 5 and 14, it says, Wherefore, thus saith the Lord, power of hosts, because he speak his word, behold, I will make my words in thy mouth fire, and this people would
and it's not the problem. So that's the bottom of the other policy. We don't have to get into fights with the devils, physically. I mean, it's written, the weapons of our warfare are not common, it's spiritual. What is the spirit? It's word. That's all it's going to take, is word to bring you down. Alright?
John chapter 18, verse 36. It says, the officer answered, my kingdom is not of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, then would my servants fight.
We're going to talk about people in the nation.